Hi, I'm Dr. Evan Matthews. I'm here at Montclair State University in the Exercise Science Lab to show you how to do a shoulder flexibility test. This test is often called a back scratch test. It's a very simple and quick test, and you'll see this all the time in exercise settings. So anytime you're going to do any sort of flexibility or stretching type exercises or tests, you want to make sure that you allow the person to warm up doing some sort of cardio respiratory exercise first. So usually 5, 10, maybe 15 minutes of a warm-up. Doing the shoulder flexibility test is very, very simple. All you do is have them put one arm up and their other arm sort of down on their side and try to touch their hands on the back of on their back. So once you have the person like that, you're going to see if they can overlap their fingers. If their fingers overlap, that is a positive flexibility score. If their fingers do not overlap, so if they are apart from each other, that's a negative flexibility score. So if they are apart from each other, you just measure the distance between the longest finger or the lowest finger on the arm that's up and the highest finger on the arm that's down. That distance between those two, just using a measuring tape, is their flexibility score. So again, it's a negative score if they don't touch. So if it's 6 centimeters between the two, that's a negative 6 centimeters for that test. So if the top hand, the bottom hand are able to go over each other, that's a positive score. So what you do then is you measure the highest part of the hand on the bottom hand and the lowest part of the hand on the upper hand and measure how much overlap there is. So if they are overlapping each other by, say, 5 centimeters, then that would be a positive 5 centimeters for their score. So again, positive scores would be overlap. Negative scores would be lack of overlap. So you're going to want to do this on the right side with the right arm up, as well as on the left side with the left arm up, because there is likely to be some difference between the right and left side. So that was a really quick introduction on how to do a shoulder flexibility test. And this is a very easy one that, again, people are using all the time in exercise settings. So if you have any questions, please put it in the comments below, and I'll try to answer those. Otherwise, please come back and watch another video. Thanks.